It would help if I was close when I want to hit someone with my shield. Dramora just vaporized. You won't get the best. You won't get that. I like it when they die in mid-sentence, and then they go, oh. That's pretty good to event Trapper. When the program's running some code, and then, oh, that person died. Let's run this code now. It's pretty fast, pretty smooth. There's no herky-jerky. In the old days, you hear a k every time a WAV file is getting interrupted to play a different WAV file. Back on the 8-bit era. Man, I can't believe I actually programmed on crapola like, you know, VIC-20s, Commodore 64s, the trash 80s, the other Commodore. What was that one called? What was the first Commodore called that had the built-in tape player? Oh, what was that one called?
Yes, Champion of Azura. What do you need?
Anyway, I programmed on that thing. I thought that had the coolest screen. It had the, whoop.
Let's go.
About to edit that out.
We've stopped. What is it? Of course.
But yeah, I thought that computer had the most high-res video screen of its kind. And it was built in. Keyboard built into the monitor, built into the tape player. Oh, what was that stupid machine called? Okay, I went on the internet. Bing says that it was the Commodore PET. What a stupid name for a computer. That stupid icicle kept pushing me around, so I'm trying to aim at the vampire to soul trap it, and I'm getting pushed around by Iceman here. But yeah, I still don't believe that I had a previous life where I programmed on 8-bit computers. That ran on less than 1 megahertz. You had to do stuff in assembly. Yeah, the 6809, I used to program in assembly. I didn't like the 6502, the 6510, eh. I like the 6809. That was my favorite CPU back then.
You came for me. How did you know? I thought I was going to die in here. Thank you.
Probably like 15 years later, I would be programming an assembly for the 8386.
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine.
What was that?
And it was okay. I still like the 6809 though.
Yours could have been dead. That's how it's done.
Nowadays, if I were to do assembly, I think I'd do the 68000. It's like the big sister to the 6809. I got a 68,000 inside of my TI-89 titanium calculator. But I haven't written any assembly yet on it. I've only written C programs for my TI-89. I've never done the assembly, and I've never done the whatever TI language that's built into the thing. It's got its own little programming language. I've never used it. I just write C programs on my computer and then upload them to the calculator and run them on the calculator. And then I have to squint like hell because it's impossible to read a screen nowadays on a TI-89. Eyeballs aren't as mushy as they normally are when you're younger. They're not as pliable. They're more like hard marbles than soft grapes. Anyway. So the, focal? The grease that makes the lens focus? That starts to turn into shellac. Lacquer. And the range of motion for your eyeball isn't quite what it used to be. Plus your brain squeezing on the back of your eyeballs, that doesn't help ever. Rigmore, you look like you have a comb over going on, but I guess not. It's just the shine coming off of her little whisker hairs on the top of her head. For a minute there, she was looking like Preventice. Yeah, the EMB I'm using exposes Rigmore's plastic painted Barbie head for what it really is. So I may have to switch over to... she's got another hairstyle where she's still got short hair, but it's like after a few weeks, her hair has grown back.
What's the matter? You can't stand the sight of a strong Nord woman? Yeah, take care.
Oh, she's gonna look way different in a future video of mine. Way different. Cause I've been playing with hair styler.
Need something? Suppose so. Got one all. You've got a deal. It's the one with the saddle.
I like hair styler. Unfortunately.
I'm sorry.
The person that made the mod. Didn't do ash color, and a lot of the oldish mature women in Skyrim use ash color hair. Hardly anyone, I guess. Yeah, hardly anyone has white hair in Skyrim. You know, literally white hair. The only person who would have white hair would be what, Aurora? You know, from X-Men. And she's not in the game. So, because the gray manes typically have that ash hair color going on, and it's hard to get hairstyler to do the same color matching. It's either going to be blonde or white. No in-between stuff. Get the attention of the spectator guards. Oh, please don't lock up on me. I hate when I come in here and it does that. I'm hitting fraps too soon. And I forget that this EMB... What's this called? The EMB post-processing? The wrapper... Oh, which one am I using? Anyway, The wrapper for this EMB is in a reverse order than the previous EMB I was using, so I could hit fraps before or after something initialized and not cause a panic on the video card. So I'm still in the habit of using my old ENB when I turn fraps on and off while I'm playing the game. It causes my ENB to hiccup.
Sir, we really must talk.
Speak.
Well, it's your son, Nelker. The boy has been acting increasingly peculiar. More so than normal, I mean. Something really should be done.
Proventus, you're my steward. Your job is to offer me counsel. This is not counsel.
Of course, sir, in times of strife.
If that's a deleted audio that's been restored, I'm glad it's been restored.
Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
All you ever do is complain about what you want. You're a spoiled baby.
I'm going to tell Father you said that. He'll tan your hide for sure.
My boys will keep you safe. Don't you worry.
I get amazing frame rate in here. It's like 60.
Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
Oh, now what's going on? Speak of the FPS devil.
Let's get going. Let's go.
I probably have some shenanigans going on. I got Sex Lab fired up. It's... what is it? For about a year and a half, I've had Sex Lab turned down
some
a notch.
Meat to fill your belly, perhaps?
Set to about 3. And now I've got Sex Lab fired up. It's on 8 or 9. I'm just doing some stress tests with Skyrim to see.
I work with my mother. Sell fruits and vegetables. It's fun most days. It's hard work.
See what the limits are while I'm video capturing the game. Because Sex Lab is super, 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 super CPU intensive.
Come to a love of her reading, did you? Sorry, Pup, but I'm not quite in the mood.
Because there's a lot of pattern matching going on. A lot. A whole bunch. Freaking lots of it. For a scene to happen in Sex Lab, you have to have room. Think of any porno movie, they take place in rooms. The kitchen, the living room, you know. There's always a couch. Sometimes there's a coffee table. Oftentimes it's just a chair involved. Anyway, you need room for these scenes to happen in. And if it's too crowded, you get the Windows 10 closing up shop and it goes bing, bing. It does its little exit out noise. Asking if you want to debug something. You're like, no, I don't want to debug something. But that's one reason why my Skyrim will crash, if Sex Lab can't find the room for certain events to happen. You know, like you teleport inside of a wall, done, the program dies. You teleport a horse stable would be like a logical place for a scene, but yeah, if there's too many barrels and too many fence posts
need a ride?
Clipping your
Where
body,
do you want to go?
Skyrim's
Climb
gonna
back and we'll be off.
Skyrim's self-awareness will kick in and cease and desist all operations of your game.
I can't wait here forever.
Where are we going? I guess we're going to Windhelm. I couldn't read what it said.
Get up there.
I need to go to that place where I got my Sam stick. I have to go back there. I think there's a Dwemer thing I have to get for the Dawnguard. So I thought I'd stop off at Windhelm Station, get my luggage, and then head southwest to the castle I'm staying in for the night. It's on the other side of this river. They say there's plenty of parking out in front. We shall see. I don't have dragon rend, so what I do is I wait for a dragon to land, and then I just hit it once with my stick. That's how I kill dragons now. I just whack it with my boomstick. Rigmar, I fought with your father. Anyway, she's almost mute in this playthrough because she's the standalone follower. She says a few things when you enter certain locations.
To talk to me after everything you've done.
Who is that? Who's mad at me? I've been killing people, so if they respond, they remember that I killed them in their previous life, and they're still upset with me. Okay, I think I was looking for my horse. My horse ran up here. How do I get up there? Can't see squat. Okay, let's head over to the hotel that we're staying in before they turn off the porch lights. I remember one time I had, was it streetlights of Skyrim installed or lampposts of Skyrim installed? Street lamps? Oh, what was that thing called? It was ridiculous. It sounded good at the time when there was very few mods at the beginning of Skyrim's life. It made sense to have, you know, street lamps on every street corner, all over the place, up and down roads, powered by candlelight, you know. It just seemed to make sense to have those things. And after a while, you're like, oh, this is ridiculous. I'm taking these out. I used to have a bunch of mods like that. It's like, oh, that's a cool mod. I need that. Oh, that's a cool mod. I'm going to get that. Downloading stuff off of Steam Workshop. Yay for Steam Workshop. Who still uses that? Yeah, anything that had 5 stars, I downloaded it. Didn't care how it worked or how crappy it was. It was 5 stars. Must be good. I've since learned my lesson. Can't trust ratings. You have to try each mod yourself.
I should get over to Windhelm Moor. See how the other Morrowind refugees are getting along.
Yeah, this is the private drive that heads up to our hotel. Looks more like a motel, if you ask me. Well, there's some people locked out of their rooms. What's going on there? Nope, we're not close enough for my Dremora to say hi and bye to the people out there. in the courtyard. Here we go. So now we can haggle about prices for the night. Cause I'm not paying full price for my bed. Anyways, my neighbors apparently are very antisocial, so. I was looking for a dead. Oh, there it is. I found you. This is probably just all black on someone's handheld computer trying to watch this video. Driscoll and his black videos with no contrast of any kind. Oh, don't go that way. That door's locked. Go that way. Kill each other. Go down this way. Oh. Oh, I hate when my game crashes like that. Let's try again. We just had too much going on. What a guy stuck in a door trying to get through. That wasn't gonna happen. Okay. Let's try without the Dremora, maybe.
Is someone there?
I can't see squat. I'm just clipping on all kinds of crap, tripping over anvils. What am I? Stepping on hot coals or something? Where am I? Maybe if I had a lamp. Speaking of lamps, I need to, I'm thinking of installing that stupid Chesco lantern thing. I'll have to check my notes and see why I stopped using that mod. Or maybe it just looked ridiculous with the EMB I was using. I don't like the turn. You turn on the lantern, the lights. The light source just looked weird. The way it was spraying light on everything. I think someone came out with a fix for it. I may have to try it. I'm not a huge fan of Chesco mods because they're so script heavy. All of them. Even the new stuff he's doing, it's just so damn script heavy. I thought Convenient Horses was script heavy enough. Oh no, that's nothing compared to his Frostfall type mods.
Never should have come here.
What's that?
There you are.
you're as good as
you are much better, Maud, than Frostfall would be hypothermia. You know, I didn't like how my sword was swinging, so I want to try again. So I went back to a previous save. As I go running up to these ladies, I hit the swing button, nothing happened. There we go. That's what I was trying to do. I probably just hit the wrong button is all. Like I said, I play Skyrim in the dark on a black keyboard. I can't see the buttons. Sometimes I'm hitting the wrong button when I need to do a power play of some kind. Could be worse. I could be playing this game with an Xbox controller. I've seen people do it. It's painful to watch their videos on YouTube. Your character suffers from the spinning mannequin disease. Or syndrome, whatever it's called. SMS, spinning mannequin syndrome. That's where you stand and spin in one space. No, you have to use a mouse and keyboard. It's more natural. It's freaking more natural. See Quake 2 for more details. There's all kinds of people in here still. It's all quiet in here. No, it's just people sleeping and all. Should I go open this door? I think I've been in here once before. Oh, hang on. Was I supposed to rescue somebody? Okay, I was supposed to rescue somebody. Yeah, I was just moving around by accident. I forgot why I was even here. I've never seen anyone in this place before.
Thank the divines. Let's move.
Well, now I know what this room's for. I didn't know it could be used for prisoner scenarios. Wow. I wish they had more quests that did, you know, rescue your friend kind of thing. Those quests are so few and far between. Most of them seem to be, oh, go kill a bandit. Oh, go fight an animal in someone's house. Oh, there's a dragon to go kill. Oh, and a giant. I had that one mod, Manny GT's notice board, is that what it's called? I played with the notice board for a while, but it's buggy as hell. Manny GT is known for the bugs.
Please get me home.
And he doesn't really come out with updates to his mods. He releases a 1.0 and that's it. 1.0 is what it's going to be forever. Someone else can fix his mistakes, so that's what I wait for. Someone else to fix the mistakes. And hopefully they don't add new mistakes to the prom.
Yes, champion of Azura.
Of course.
But yeah, the notice board had too many problems. It was breaking NPCs that would get sent to prison. So that's a pet peeve of mine.
Let's go. What do you need, Guardian?
NPCs should be either brought back alive or killed in the process, but not brought back half-ass. You know, Landon.
Together we will vanquish any.
I don't want any Landons in my game. That's a reference to a Planet of the Apes. Taylor goes walking up to the guy, Landon, and he turns him around. He's got, "You cut up his brain, you bloody baboon." Anyway.
I'll be sure to put it to good use.
I'm just seeing which outfits I can get her to wear. And have the,
Are you ready?
The circlet thing on her head. Because when she wears the hooded outfit, that counts as one whole piece. One whole ensemble. And I don't have the patch that, breaks clothes up into different pieces. I don't want to deal with that nonsense. You end up with half-naked people walking around all the time. I'd rather have everyone totally naked or totally clothed, but not the in-between stuff. It's too much to keep track of.
What can I do for you? Are you ready? What can I do for you, friend?
I don't like the mage boots for some reason.
It's the least I can do.
They're like knee-high moon boots. Don't like them. What else we got? I mean, just vampire boots might look better than what she had on.
Let's go.
Eh. Those look better, I guess. Playing dress up in the dark, in the snow, with dragons, about a boat. If you're from Canada, you say a boat. Man, there's a gas main leak at our hotel. It's a safety hazard right there. I'm gonna file a report. Are these some stragglers? Who are these?
Talos Wills!
Someone do something! Stormcloaks! Talos
never should have come here. Yeah!
Anyway, this constant eating of human beings is kind of a cheat. Because it makes your stamina regenerate pretty quick.
Please get me home.
But the effect doesn't last very long, though. What is it like? I want to say it lasts for, 2 minutes, 3 minutes? And then it's gone. It's probably good to have when you're in combat, but you don't really need it when you're just sightseeing like I am now. Well, just like in my other playthrough, this one I'm starting to like the Dawnbreaker sword I'm using. It's pretty flimsy and weak when you first get it.
Death to the dawn.
But it does that. It makes things blow up. When you get good at using it, you have to have the perks to get good at using it. And then stuff starts to explode around you when you swing it about at a dead person. But it's still weak as far as how much damage it does with each hit. It still looks cool. It's got the cool effect because I got modded textures on it. Someone scribbled some stuff on the blade. The bright flare from the handle, though, makes my pupils dilate. Or do the reverse of dilate. Whatever it is. So then I have to squint to play my game in the dark. Because I'm staring at this blinding light in the corner of my screen.
Need a ride? Where do you want to go? Climb and back and we'll be off.
Wow, so the majority of this video was in the dark. I came here at night, went to the hotel, and got out of Dodge before the sun came up. We have to... gotta take this person home, it looks like.
I hear there's whole countries full of them down south.